In 1938, Russian air forces enhanced the range of some of their fighter planes by 80%, while carrying bombs that were twice as heavy. Yet only small modifications were made to these fighters. How was this possible? I'll give you that one more time. In 1938, Russian air forces enhanced the range of some of their fighter planes by 80% while carrying bombs that were twice as heavy. Yet only small modifications were made to these fighters. How was this possible?
You know how in printers, they will often have for their ink cartridges, like a limiter after a certain number of pages to like stop them from printing, even though there's still ink in there. And now I'm just thinking, is there like a limiter in the engine in some way? And they were like, oh, if we just like take that out, then it'll just fly for way longer.
What if it's even like stupider than that? It was like the fuel gauge. It said there was like it was empty, but actually it was just reading the wrong amount. And so they're like, oh, we can go further.
Many years ago, I watched Colin Furze, if you know him, bypass the limiter on a golf cart. And it turns out that the limiter on a golf cart is just like a little thing. Like it took him 2 or 3 minutes. We were building a thing for a show. And he just kind of went, oh, yeah, now I have to do this. Kind of fiddled with the engine for a while. And suddenly the thing went twice as fast as it was meant to.
Is it maybe the least surprising Colin Furze story
yes.
I've ever heard?
Yes.
This makes perfect sense. Could the bombs have doubled as fuel?
It's not that, but I feel like you should work in the Ministry of Interesting Wartime Ideas back in the 1930s, when they were just sort of throwing everything out there to see what would work.
That's very kind. I want you to know the humility as I walked into that so slowly, being like, oh, I don't want to ruin this episode by getting this question. I want you to know how much I was like, is this okay? Should I run this by producer David to see if it's okay to say this answer that quickly?
Because completely wrong. Sorry.
Oh God.
If this is an actual technology thing, I have nothing. But if it's like some kind of ridiculous workaround, we can get there.
Part of me was like, if you have extra mass because of the mass of the bombs, therefore like when you launch off of like a ramp or a roller coaster, you'll get extra
you
the mask on going down and then you launch from that. Also, part of me, I know something about how like, you know, if you go high enough in the jet stream that like certain factors don't matter as much. And also maybe then on the way down, you go faster because you're descending with more mass and therefore actually you can go farther. Physics.
That might work over short distances, but this is extending the range, like the entire range of the fighters.
Yeah. And I assume by range, you mean like distance it can travel.
Yep.
Okay.
Huh.
Was it fewer bombs, but they increased the size of them? I don't know if there's some trick in the wording there.
Or even the opposite way around, if it was like more bombs, but lighter, so that they would drop them quicker, and therefore it was lighter in the long run.
Oh, yeah, like they're lighter on the way back when they drop them?
It was certainly very different on the way back.
Oh, boy. The most ominous answer for that.
The fuel efficiency was far, far better at the start of the journey, though.
They put in pedals so you can charge the... it's like a Flintstones car. You could run along the ground with the plane.
I thought you were doing like a Chicken Run vibe of like they pedal and then it flaps. That's what I thought.
Is it wheels? Did they add wheels to the plane that before there were no wheels, so it couldn't take off properly or land properly? Or
it's safe to say that while the fighters themselves weren't really modified, there is something quite big going on here.
Did they create really big catapults that flung them into the air so that they didn't have to use fuel to take off, and therefore their fuel efficiency was better?
No, but you're along the right lines.
Oh, wow.
Like, there is definitely some help being received here.
They just pushed the plane to save the fuel at the start.
How would you push a plane?
Very hard.
Difficultly?
Difficultly.
They pulled the plane to get the speed up with a...
That wouldn't give you 80%.
Yeah.
80% is a ton. It's a lot. That's almost so much that it feels like there's like has to be. It's more of a trick than it is like an actual like improvement. Maybe I'm wrong here though. So they doubled the mass of the bombs on the plane and improved it 80%. And on the return,
so you're not using a catapult. You're not using a slingshot or anything like that. You're using something that that can go a lot further than that.
Another plane.
What?
Talk me through how that might work.
No. I said those words. I did. Ah, yes, yes. And of course, every word I say, I think through carefully. So just give me a second to organize my plan schematics.
What, like one really big plane that had...
A plane that carries the second plane.
Yes, Caroline, you've nailed it.
Oh!
This was what they called parasite aircraft.
Oh!
Love that. So I'm back
this
on board.
This is a Tupolev heavy bomber loaded with up to 5 fighter craft attached to it.
No.
Why am I still talking about fuel efficiency here? Why do we just not phrase this as, oh, they took the planes out and launched them from there?
Because it includes the fuel of the big plane as well, right? So it's the fuel efficiency of all of them together rather than like individual journeys.
Yes. I feel like you're picturing they fly the planes there and then they kind of just spool the engines up and go.
That is what I'm picturing.
Are all of the engines on?
All of the engines are on.
The engines of the smaller planes are on.
Yes. That's why the efficiency was so great. They have locked all these together to make one weird, like, Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Giant, colossal plane with up to 6 engines and 6 propellers all working in tandem, and then when they get near to the destination, they can disconnect the fighters and send them off.
I'm picturing those, is it the crocodiles that have like the birds on them, but then the birds are also flapping to help make the crocodiles like run faster. Oh my gosh.
And the other reason they do that is because the same kind of way that cyclists will work together as a pack and help each other with fuel efficiency, the planes in that close proximity also boost each other, and together they work better.
Wow.
So yes, this was the parasite aircraft system that the Russian Air Force invented in the 1930s to moderate success. It wasn't one of these things that just completely vanished. They actually did have some success with it, where the small fighter planes were attached to a heavy bomber for the journey out. The Lateral book is out now. Just click on the link to get your copy.